So what is surrealist photography and how do we go about making some? Well, hello, welcome to the Fotospeed YouTube channel. As always, with me, Tim Jones. This week, I am looking at a subject that is quite close to my heart, which is surrealism. Now, our monthly theme for our FS monthly competition is surrealism and everything weird and wonderful that comes along with that. Now, you can enter that competition on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook just by using the hashtag FSMonthly. And then me and Sam will do a live probably at the start of next month and picking three winners, which will each win a £50 voucher for Fotospeed papers and also a print made by myself. Now, like I said, surrealism is a subject that's quite close to my heart, to be honest, because I think my work and has always been sitting within the surrealist and uncanny and otherworldly kind of camp of kind of types of photography. So I really just wanted to make a video this month on surrealism and how we can go about making some really nice, simple surrealist pieces and surrealist photographs in the style of Man Ray. Now, I've picked Man Ray because he is probably one of the most forefront and the most recognisable kind of names when you talk about surrealist photography and the work that he produced. Now, be it his photograms or rayograms, as he coined them, or his solarisation work, how he took the everyday and took it into a dreamlike state and it made it almost otherworldly. Now, this is what surrealism is all about. Surrealism was started probably in the 1920s, just after the First World War. And it came about by a French writer called André Breton. Now, he first wrote the Surrealist Manifesto, which I have a copy of here, in 1924. And he talks about, within this manifesto, talks about the dream state and the state of automation, be it through writing and literature or painting, and art in general and the spoken word as well. So there was a lot of talk about automation, say automatic writing and automatic drawing and things like that in here. Now, photography was a big part of this as well because there was that photographic revolution happening in the early 1920s and into the 30s and 50s. Now, this massive revolution of this new technology as the camera and of the photograph. Now, up until that point, photography had been a scientific kind of object. The photograph was there to record life, record fact, and record an object in its natural state. However, what the Surrealist movement did, and Man Ray, is take the photograph and almost flip it on its head and take the photograph back into the unconscious in our mind and show another world and what the object could be if we saw it in a different way, which I think is fascinating and really good way to use photography. Now, like I said, one of the pioneers of this movement was Man Ray. Now, Man Ray is probably more famous for inventing solarization, a process where when you're developing a print in the darkroom, you flick on the light for a few moments and you get this kind of half negative, half positive kind of look. But he started off by doing something called a photogram. Now, a photogram is where we put an object on top of a piece of paper and we then expose the photographic paper or light sensitive material, which is underneath the light, and we get a silhouette or a shadow of that object. Now, because we're looking at real objects and things that actually exist, I think surrealist photography straddles two kind of camps, should we say, in the art world. We've got surrealism on one side and the Dada movement on the other, with Deschamps and his ready-mades and things. However, it kind of sits in between because we're looking at ready-made objects and the photogram is showing this new object in another light. So it's almost surrealist in that kind of sense, that dream state and unconscious. So it's really interesting and I think it straddles those lines really nicely. So what I thought today in this video was I'll show you how we can do these Man Rayograms or rayograms really simply at home without a darkroom and without any expensive enlargers or anything like that. We can very simply do this with a little bottle of cyanotype solution from Fotospeed and some lovely paper. So this all comes in our cyanotype kit as well. So we can do these really simply. So all we need is some objects that we're gonna kind of make photograms of. So we're gonna coat some paper as well with the cyanotype solution, let it dry, and then we'll expose those to make our lovely photograms. And then we can have an experiment with different objects as well and have a look. Okay, so first thing I need to do is coat some paper ready for my photograms and ready for use. Okay, so let me do that first. I'll show you how easy it is and how nice and simple it is with our kit. And then we'll dive in and actually start making some rareograms. Okay, so here I am. I'm just about to coat my papers. So the first thing I need to do is just get my bottle of cyanotype sensitizer. And what I'm gonna do is just get my paper here. I've got some quite big sheets actually here, but I'm just gonna get some and just basically just put some on the sheets. And then with my brush that I have over here, I'm just gonna then coat the paper just across. Now I thought I put quite a bit on here, but because these are quite big sheets, it does go quite far. So I'm just gonna go like this. I don't like having neat edges on mine. So I like having the rough brush marks as well. So I'm just brushing this all in here. And then I basically do this process on each sheet. Now I should say we do this in a darkened room as well. So we have a dull, dim light. We don't want it to be exposing the paper. Okay, so while the paper's drying, I am just gonna talk you through kind of a few of the objects I've chosen. So the first thing is gonna be, I've picked some plastic bags and some tissue paper. Just gonna put that on the sheet of paper just to see how it reacts to the light and things. It's gonna be quite interesting because the plastic bag's quite see-through and the tissue paper will be quite solid. So we'll get some nice gradients, I think, going on. The other thing I have is a roll of Fotospeed tape. So that's gonna be quite interesting to use. Now, the other thing I have is an old valve out of an amplifier. Quite interested to see how this reacts as well, because there's little components inside, it's see-through, so light can pass through the valve and things. So yeah, really interested with that. So let me just wait for the paper to dry. And it should take about 20 minutes, half an hour. It's really warm today, so it is gonna take not as long. And then we'll dive outside and create some lovely cyanotype photograms. So I have made the prints. I went and exposed them. Then I gave them a quick wash for about 10 minutes just to get all the sensitizer off, or the excess sensitizer, should I say, off the prints. And now I have some finished prints. So I've let them to dry. And I think the most successful one, whichever way around we're gonna put it, is the roll of Fotospeed tape and the old valve there. Worked really well. Now, the reason why the tube is off to the center a little bit is because of the placement of the sun was coming in that way. So casted a bit of a shadow. And I really like that effect. I think if we were using a dark room or kind of an enlarger in a dark room, you probably wouldn't get that effect unless we put the enlarger on its side or in something. So I really like that. And I think this was the most successful one. And it's really kind of given new life to these objects in the picture here. We're kind of thinking, well, what are they? What's going on in here? What's happening? It's creating that doubt. And I think that's quite nice and what surrealism kind of can give us. Now, there's a couple of other ones. I just did the valve on its own. Again, I think it works quite nicely with something. But again, really nice. Actually got a little bit of the lettering on here as well. But the really interesting one as well, which really kind of abstracted almost, was the tissue paper in the bag in here. And it is given this almost kind of map or kind of another object or something growing or something. We can go into all the art speak and kind of think, what does it mean? But there's lovely different tones of blue in here as well, which really creates a lovely print. And I'm really happy with them. I think the most successful ones are probably this one here, and also the valve and the tape. So they've worked really well. So as you can see, it's quite a nice kind of fun process to do. If you wanted something to do when it's a bright sunny day like it is today, and you wanted to get out but not go too far with your camera and things and still do something quite photographic, the cyanotype process makes it lovely and easy because you don't need a darkroom or any specialist equipment. Just a cyanotype kit from Fotospeed and off you go. Well, I hope that's been useful, and I hope that has kind of given you a way to think a little bit more out of the box, perhaps, and introduce our monthly theme of surrealism to you. Don't forget to enter all your surrealist pictures on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook using the hashtag FSMonthly. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, goes without saying. And also, if you needed any Fotospeed papers, please use the discount code FSYouTube15 to get 15% off your next purchase on photospeed.com. So until next time, have an amazing week, and I will see you again. Bye-bye.